And we are live. Welcome to the Hellqvist Hammond Hour, coming for you from the Hellqvist headquarters in Uppsala, Sweden. I'm checking the chat and I'm seeing some friends already there. Palle Christensen in the same town. And Joel, hello. Kul att se dig. And Lelle has commented in the chat, but in fact, Lelle, who I've met on these streams many times, he's actually here. In fact, I have a bunch of people here in as a live audience at the HQ. Let me hear you. Are you? Yay! Yes. So we're having a kind of a party here, and we're hoping to share that party with you and have a good time. It's been a while. It's 3 weeks ago since I did my last stream, so I've really been looking forward to doing this. And let's waste no more time. I have some things to tell you, but I'll do it later. Let's just start with something. Let's start with the blues. Last weekend I had a marvelous gig at a place here in town, and we played a Jack McDuff tune called A Real Gooden. So let's do that. A Real Gooden.
Thank you.
Oh, classic. Classic. Unmute. Yes. Okay. So what I just said was pointless. But yeah, I've just said hello to all you who have written in the chat. Nice to see you, everyone, and hope more will join in. And if you're watching this, do write something. Do write something in the chat. I think I need to just fix one little thing. Wait a minute. Okay, small technical issues. Let's just go on with the show. Okay. Yeah. So I have a bunch of friends here, and so I'm gonna do a few requests from them, and I'm gonna. But this show will also be quite a lot of. It'll be like a Swedish theme, and I'll tell you why. But let me see. But yeah, let's do this. Yesterday, I was at the, like, this was the last day of the Stockholm Jazz Festival, and yesterday I went to see Rhoda Scott, a legend, a living legend, Rhoda Scott. She played in Stockholm yesterday, and she played this song. I think it was the opening tune. I heard it, and I thought, I'm going to check it out, and I'm going to see if I can play it today. So I thought I'd do it. This one's called City of the Rising Sun. City of the Rising Sun. Thank you. Okay, thank you so much. A fun song, I just heard it yesterday, so it took a while for it to settle, but I think it did in the end. So, City of the Rising Sun. So what I gather, there should be a collection of houses of the rising sun, right? I don't know. Anyway, nice song, nice happy tune. We're having a bit of a party here, so that's just in the spirit of the evening. Okay. Yeah, so about this Swedish theme that I talked about. So a couple of things. So first let me just do one of the requests that was like highest on the list from the guests. I don't know if it was highest, but anyway, when we speak about Shirley Scott, so they're like she's one of the great female organ players, and in Sweden we have one of the greats are Merit Hemmingsson. And I thought I'd do a tune that she, a folk melody that she did in the 70s that became very popular, and is a bridal march, and it's called Jämtländsk brudmarsch. And that was for my group of people here, especially Lelle, maybe, but because you said you are from Jämtland, the place where this originated. So it's called Jämtländsk brudmarsch, which is like a bridal march from this region of Sweden. Okay. Okay, let's see. Okay, Christer. Okay, yes. yeah, the records Hova, especially one record, was played quite a lot when I was a kid. So this song brings me back memories from my childhood as well. So it's nice. And okay, Dieter, welcome to the show. Well, no worries. You drop in at any time. Glad to see you here. And thank you, Joel. And yes, I'm gonna continue here to see. So let's do something a little more calm. And the thing is, earlier this week or earlier this month, this thing in Sweden is called Svensktoppen, which is the like a top list of Swedish songs, and it's been around for 60 years now. And and of course, a lot of the songs are like genuinely Swedish, like there's a Swedish composer and lyrics, but some of them and many of them are like American songs that have gotten a Swedish lyrics. I think the requirements have shifted over the years. For a while, it had to be like only Swedish compositions, but it can be like American songs but with Swedish lyrics. That's the thing that they just have to have Swedish lyrics. Anyway, one of the songs that has been on this list the longest is, I think the English title is Same Old Story, but in Swedish it was called Håll Mitt Hjärta, Hold My Heart. So I thought I'd do that. It's kind of a sad song, but it's beautiful at the same time, so let's try it. Same old story, and let it Håll Mitt Hjärta.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's see. Eddie from Belgium. Hello there. Nice to see you. And thank you, Dieter. Okay, Janne. Söderholm. Vad fint. The Saturday Hammond family, as I refer to it, is gathering. It's really nice. And it's nice to have you both online on the internet, and it's nice to have an audience also here physically at the HQ. Might get lonely here sometimes, but it's... So it's nice to have both, and I think it's such a nice combination of two worlds. Those were two quite a little sadder songs, perhaps. So let's do something a little... let's just do a standard. Another song I got to play this week, and I haven't played it in a while. So let's just do Teach Me Tonight. It's a song that I love. I used to listen, I do listen once in a while when one of my biggest idols, Kjell Öhman, plays it with his organ grinders. So this is for Kjell, Teach Me Tonight.
Thank you.
Aha, let's see. Now we're getting some input from this. This is kind of a meta experience. I'm reading a comment from a guy who's sitting approximately five meters from me. Mikael Jansson, the song is written by a Swede. Okay, sung by Blue Spin. Okay. Hmm. Är det så alltså? Teach me tonight. Vad är originalets titel?
Den heter alltså. Ja.
Ah, okay. So the previous song. Okay, so same old story is a Swedish tune from the beginning. I did not know that. I apologize to Sweden. I'm very sorry. okay. Hey. Okay. And Tim Allman have joined in, marveling in Medora. Where is Medora? I don't know where that is. Quirin as well from Germany. Back to one Leslie. No, I'm back to one Leslie in the screen, but that's just because I have a drum kit on the other. So I just chose this angle to make it as organ focused as possible. So I don't have all the space to myself right now. I've been recording a little with drums here during the week, but. What you're hearing is there are two Leslies connected in the stream. So there are two. There's my, what you see behind me is my 147, and I have the 122 in the other corner that you don't see. So two Leslies, going from four, it feels kind of little, but it'll do. Okay. Hey. New Orleans, okay. Hello, Dan and Jay. Okay. Now, that was Teach Me Tonight, and... okay, now I'm going to do, speaking of Swedish songs, and I checked, like, this day, I don't know what year, but a few years ago on this day, so... Best song in the best song in the Eurovision Song Contest, I think, and it was on this day a couple of years ago. So Waterloo was voted the best song, you know, ABBA's Waterloo, and I was thinking, is it possible to do something with that? It's been like overplayed, but I sat here fiddling around with it, and I found a way that just might work for this occasion. We're having a party, and so this is my party version of Waterloo. And for this, I think I would also need a clap from the audience. And you can clap at home if you want as well. Men ska vi prova på 2-4? It will be the soul jazz or something version of Waterloo. So here it goes. Thank you. Okay. I heard. I left the mic on. I hope you heard my fabulous audience here. As I usually say, there's no better. If they can pull it off, there's no better accompaniment than a 2-4 clap. But the interesting thing, I was at the Rhoda Scott concert yesterday, and she had this French band, and they said, and the last tune they played was this Ray Charles, What I Say. And then they got a clap going in the audience, and they played it, and it worked well. But afterwards, they spoke about it, and they said that we couldn't do this in France because they would clap on the 1 and 3 instead. And that's not unusual in Sweden, I would say either. So, but I've been lucky so far. So yeah. I mean, and I have to admit that I like that tune. It might be that the original version, you've heard it maybe one too many times, but when you start playing around with it, and with all ABBA, most ABBA tunes, they're brilliant compositions, and yeah. So yeah, Waterloo. Okay. Facebook user says no YouTube today. Yo, yes, YouTube. You have people watching, so just go to my channel. Like, I would encourage all of you, if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, go to go there, subscribe. Also, I have to mention this, do join my Patreon. You can do that for $3 a month, and you can also contribute with either PayPal or in Sweden through Swish. But the easiest way, if you like what I do, if you want to contribute, sign up for the Patreon. It'll take $3 a month, and it'll be an incentive to do more things like that. This. Okay. So that was Waterloo, and we're on like the home stretch of this theme. Let's see what do I have to play to not miss any of the fun stuff that I plan. But yeah, let's do another calm song. So, yeah, let's do this one. This is a cute song. So last week I had this organ party thing at a place in my here in Uppsala, and it was me. I brought my B3, two Leslies, and a Swedish kind of legend. Her name is Monica Dominic, and she has like played with everyone and sing, and she plays the organ, she plays the grand piano, sings, practically has done it all, and a fantastic, it was so nice to meet her, play with her. It was the first time we met, but I hope it won't be the last, and it was such a heartfelt just meeting, concert, everything. And she was singing at the grand piano, and I was singing at the organ. Anyway, she worked a lot with another Monica, who's maybe the biggest name in Swedish jazz, Monica Zetterlund, who, by the way, did a whole lot of stuff with Bill Evans. So do check that out if you haven't heard it. And lots of other stuff, of course, as well. But yeah, and she... so where was I? Yes. Anyway, so maybe someone can correct me on this one as well. But so Monica Zeta did we played this tune called Gröna små äpplen, and there I think the original is Green Little Apples, and that is not a Swedish tune, yes. But it got a Swedish some translation, and quite literal, Green Little Apples. So let's play that. That's a really cute song. Thank you. Green Little Apples. Okay, thank you. Hello, Terry. Terry Linder from California, Orange County. And so Toby, are you the one behind hiding behind? I didn't see a name on your when you were on Facebook. So it just said Facebook user. So but I see you here on YouTube. So nice to see you. So that was Green Little Apples. So now I want to do some Latin thing that I also played there on the same concert. I think I'm gonna do a samba. That was so fun. And this is I may ask you to sing. We'd like to sing. Yeah. Okay. So fun. We got in Sweden. We love allsång, where we all sing together. So we're gonna do a little allsång. This is a tune called Tristeza, and we can practice. Let's practice the. It's a chorus that'll come. So let's practice that first. Nice. Okay, let's try that. So here is Tristeza. Thank you. Fint. Now, I may have turned off my mic there, so maybe you didn't hear much of the singing. But, yeah, I do that. It's just a reflex, so, ah well. But, okay, so let's do, I think that this will be the last one. Yeah, I got another request. We're having a party, so let's just continue the party. I got another request of a tune that I recorded as like an... Actually, I was demonstrating this particular organ at the Swedish Hammond office, and this is a video. It's still up. You can find it. I'm actually using this organ, and Leslie, you're not... I have... That is standing beside me, but not in a place where you can see it right in the stream. But anyway... I thought I'd play you Sunny, and yes, Sunny. Okay, so that'll be probably at least the official final song of this stream.
Thank you.
Okay, nice. Thank you so much. Okay, so that was the Hammond Hour this time. I can tell you there will be a stream next week, and I won't give you all the details now, but I think there will be a guest here as well. So stay tuned, I'll post information. I've been working a lot with my website lately, so it's worth paying a visit to andreashellqvist.com. I'm working on it continuously, and it's you can find a lot of things there, and you will be able to find things there that you won't find anywhere else. So it's worth clicking around. You can see a lot of stuff about the things that I do, the things that I will do, and the stuff that I have done. So you can find a lot of old sins there, and I'm adding them by the minute. When you're there, do sign up for the newsletter. And for you in the room, if you haven't signed up, do sign up for the newsletter. Subscribe on YouTube. Subscribe, like the Hammond Organist page on Andreas Hellqvist Hammond Organist on Facebook, if you like this. And I hope I'll see you next week. But of course, I won't leave you without something. I'll play something. So let's do. Okay, so Willie Newell has been on me for this. So I'm gonna do a little thing for him, and then I think I have the perfect ending song. But first, a little thing for Willie. Green Onions, but I haven't played it in a while, so it'll be a short one. But it'll be a chance to try my distortion module here. So let's see. Yeah, okay. Oh, well. Okay. Thank you so much. Green Onions. No, but I think that'll be it for today. Nice finish, nice growl in the finishing song. And yeah, so next week, do check back. I'll be here. I hope you'll be there somewhere. And thank you, my wonderful live audience today. I applaud you.